Yay! Bravo, bravo.
Thank you, everyone. You know, they say that retirement is supposed to be no stress, but getting up in front of 70 or 80 people, whatever, that's stress.
Problem solved.
So first I want you to know that I'm overjoyed and honored to celebrate my retirement with all of you. You were invited because in one fashion or another, you played an important and supportive role in my career with State Farm. Whether you're family, friend, team member, current or in the past, client of many years, manager or employee of State Farm, fellow agent, babysitter, housekeeper, or our official mailman. I don't see him here. I appreciate every one of you who have contributed to my success, in this wonderful career. Thank you. The person I have the most to thank for my success is not here with us today in body, but is in spirit. That person is my wonderful mother.
Yes.
She was the one who encouraged me always to get me off the couch after 2 hours when I was assigned the daunting project of getting 500 people that were willing to compare their insurance before becoming an agent. We call that ex dating for those of you who are not in the business, but it doesn't mean dating your ex. My mother was always dedicated to making my appointments by cold calling from the phone book. Remember the phone book? For the first 3 or 4 years of my career, she would make all my appointments and I would be the closer. Not too bad. Having been divorced when my daughter Lauren was less than a year old, I had great support of Aida, who's here, and Kim, who helped me with my house and with Lauren as I was busy building my agency. My first State Farm manager, Stan Barkey, who's also here, was 100% committed to my success and was there to hold my hand when I needed it, and I was very green, as one would say. I didn't even know what liability was 2 weeks before. I remember being on El Monte and El Camino, and he goes, okay, now I've got to explain the different coverages for car insurance. And that was 2 weeks before opening my doors. Training's a lot different now. Another person to thank is retired agent, State Farm agent Tempe Javis, who is here today, who basically introduced me to State Farm, as well as answered a zillion questions for the first several months. I probably had 5 to 6 questions a day, and I would just pick up the phone and call them. She was always patient and helped me when I needed it the most. I really wish I had the time to thank each and every one of you individually, but know that you are all appreciated and very thankful. My first, very first employee, Ernestine, I'm touched. There she is. To here today, who has been with State Farm ever since her first position with my office. She's now in Los Angeles. The thing I remember the most about her is she would always make me laugh and not take things too seriously, which those of you who know me well, me, I can be serious if you have someone out there that's supposed to be smiling. It's always been the highest priority of mine to take care of my clients, and I've been so so fortunate to have wonderful team members along the way that understood what it means to be able to provide outstanding customer service. Thank you to all of you who are here today. I could not have done it without you. I also want to thank Jim Baer for so many things, but found two of my four offices and has always been my very best cheerleader in whatever I do.
Bravo.
I want to share a few highlights I recall of my career. I recall vividly the first house that I knocked on the door after 2 hours on the couch. I was scared to death. It was in Redwood City. The guy answered the door, and I said, "Hi, I'm with State Farm." And I kind of stopped, and he goes, "I hate State Farm."
Oh, my God.
I'm shaking. I'm like, oh, my God, I don't know what to do. But he came quickly back and said, "You seem like a really nice lady, and you're doing the right thing, so just keep doing what you're doing, and you'll be successful someday." So I walked away, and I'm like,
like the Oscars.
So I was happy to say I had 8 estates on my first 1 square mile expedition in my mom's neighborhood, and many of those turned into clients once I opened my agency. I recall my personal office and my private office was really dark. So there was a saw in the office. Remember that old-fashioned wood paneling that everybody had? We just took the saw and cut a hole in it so I had light to look out to have some more light. Another thing I recall was when I splurged and bought my first fax machine. It was $600 for the most basic fax machine. And my manager, Stan Barkey, came to my office and he said, "Why did you do that? Why did you ever buy something like that? Nobody's ever going to use it." Well, he didn't quite get that right, but he very rarely steers me wrong. A third great memory was when two of my clients who are here today taught me that price is not everything. In my first month as an agent, I went to people's homes to give presentations comparing insurance. And it turned out we were way more expensive. So what did I do? I stuck my, my papers and whatever in a briefcase, started to pack up, walk out the door, and they're like, wait, where are you going? I said, "Well, we're way more money." And they go, "Well," "price is the most important thing. We like you, and we trust you, and come back here. We want to write our insurance with you." And they were with me my entire career. Changing the subject a little bit, I'd like to go down memory lane and reflect on how many things have changed over the 36 plus years. Some I feel good about and some not so good. From the day of writing a policy on carbonized paper applications to looking up policy records on a microfiche reader, sliding the little thing back and forth until you could find the client's name, to now almost everything is done electronically. From not allowing team members to be licensed, to now, it's mandatory that team members be licensed. From file note cards you place in a little black speckled box with dividers January through December 1-31, pending information of when to follow up on something. Now everything is electronic and client activities. In the beginning, every new client had a hard file called a master record folder with tons of paper related to a client, especially those yellow organized papers where you would send one into the company and the other one you keep in your file, but you could hardly read what it would say. You didn't press hard enough then. From hands written handwritten signatures to electronic signature pads from a slide rule, which I brought.
Oh, yes.
To now, about a 7-page document called a 360 with details of every room in the house. From the ability to insure someone with two claims, sometimes three, with approval to now zero claims in 3 years. From rate manuals for rules and quoting to everything is now online. I actually preferred when we had manuals because I knew how to find everything. This is commercial, this is personal, whatever, just look it up. I had little tabs marked. Now, everything's on the computer and I'm struggling to find where it is to find the information that I need to know about. So I can go on and on of all the changes, but one that sticks to me is how the phone used to ring off the hook. It was our main way of communicating for mostly everything. But now everything is mostly email. I'm old-fashioned and I prefer to communicate verbally with my clients and found that it was much easier to develop stronger bond and relationship from what I find a more impersonal email or a text. However, it's just the way people do things today, so I had to learn to adjust, but I still say that's one of the things that I preferred the way things were before. So, fast forward, looking forward to the next chapter of my life. Fortunately, I'm blessed with good health and want to be able to enjoy the things I know I enjoy the most and to have opportunity to explore new things that I haven't tried. Some of the things I plan to do and need to do is get more sleep, don't write emails at 2 or 3 in the morning, organize closets, drawers, garage, enjoy my gardening and love of orchids and succulents.
All right, we got her some orchids.
Maintain my fitness level. Cook more and try more complex recipes that take more time. Travel. Try playing my violin again. Perhaps have a dog, but well, I have to tell you, I have to have a dog because this is what my daughter gave me.
All right, yeah. Yeah.
And done. So, I guess I could take it off. Knitting, volunteering, and spend more time with family and friends.
Rogue.
To wrap things up, it has been an amazing career, better than I could have ever imagined. Being an agent has given me the opportunity to place my drive and energy into building such a great relationship, both in work and in friendship, and ultimately have had 36-year amazing career. For those of you I may not see again ever, or at least for a long time, you will truly be missed. And to others, I look forward to seeing you more often. Thank you all from the bottom of my heart.
Bravo.